pause now to tune in this Proms performance of Bach's B Minor Mass live tonight on Radio 3. And for the Lutheran congregations back in 1733, the Gloria marked the end of a Missa Brevis, but we're far from the end tonight in Bach's Mass in B Minor, the Credo next, as John Butt directs this performance with the orchestra and choir of the Age of Enlightenment.
Thank you. Padre, Filio, Thank you.
I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. The Credo from Johann Sebastian Bach's Mass in B minor. This proms performance with the orchestra and choir of the Age of Enlightenment, directed from the harpsichord by John Butt. And in that Credo, soloist soprano Rachel Redmond, countertenor Yestin Davis and bass Matthew Brook. Before it's in the Kyrie and Gloria, they were joined by soprano Mary Bevan and tenor Guy Cutting. Well, a stage shuffle now for the choir. And earlier I asked John more about the construction of the Mass, the sense of Bach gathering and recrafting treasured music into a spiritual portfolio.
I think at the point at which the Mass in B minor became famous in the first third or so of the 19th century, if people had really known how much of it was actually taken from other sources, which is virtually all of it, a few bits are new, they would have thought it was unoriginal, as they did of the other masses that Bach did, because they connected to cantatas. But in fact, some of them, I think, relate to unknown works that we can tell are parallel works but are lost. And it's not just a question of adding new text, as sometimes Bach did, and just leaving the music exactly as it was. In the case of the five-part choruses, he actually really added the fifth part by rewriting at least two of the others. So it was actually quite an effort to get that fifth part in.
John Butt talking to me earlier. Well, the Sanctus coming up was written for Bach's first Christmas in Leipzig. And can you imagine this glorious music just going back in the cupboard afterwards? John Butt was talking there about adding fifth parts for the choruses, but here Bach adds a further part. And so the choir, who are making their way back on stage now, they'll be singing in six parts. And this is no accident in reworking the music for the Mass. As Bach returns to the text from Isaiah in Old Age, the song of the celestial seraphim with their six wings seems to be the impetus for six voices. It's just the sort of symbolism that meant even more to him at the end of his life and with which this Mass is filled. Well, the choir are reconfigured back on stage. The orchestra, led tonight by Hugh Daniel, retuned. We're ready to move on with the Sanctus.
Sanctus, 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 scream.